just listen to the words of the songs and just bless the Lord today like we've never blessed him before. In Jesus' name, amen.
Spirit, 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 we live. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Good morning, church. Oh, my Lord, I'm so stirred. Praise the Lord. Our call to worship comes to us from Psalms 136 this morning. And I'm hoping that we can all do this together, like it will be in the spirit of cooperation, I guess. As I read each line, your line is, His love endures forever. Okay? Amen. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the God of gods. His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord of lords. His love endures forever. To Him who alone does great wonders, His love endures forever. Who by His understanding made the heavens, His love endures forever. Who spread out the earth upon the waters, His love endures forever. Who made the great lights, His love endures forever. The sun to govern the day, His love endures forever. The moon and the stars to govern the night, His love endures forever. To Him who remembered us in our low estate, His love endures forever. And freed us from our enemies, His love endures forever. He gives food to every creature. His love endures forever. Give thanks to God of heaven. His love endures forever. Again, His love endures forever. Amen. So I just want to welcome you here this morning on behalf of Reverend Joyce Ross, the leadership team, and everybody. We want to welcome you to East Preston United Baptist Church, where we are empowering people, united, and becoming like Christ. EPUBC. Have a blessed morning.
Who has the invitation prayer? Repeat it. There's no God like Jehovah. No God like Jehovah. Such a blessing to be here. No Zoom. To see everybody's faces live is absolutely beautiful, and we're blessed. It's a blessing to be in the house of the Lord. Amen. The responsive reading this morning is Psalms 26, from verses 1 to 6. O Lord, for I have walked in mine integrity. I have trusted also in the Lord. Therefore, I shall not slide.
Test me, Lord, and try me. Examine my heart and my mind.
For thy loving kindness is before mine eyes, and I have walked in thy truth.
I do not sit with the deceitful, nor do I associate with the hypocrites.
I have hated congregation of evildoers, and will not sit with the wicked.
I wash my hands of innocence.
Oops.
Thank you, Lord, for your word. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Good morning.
Good morning.
Let us pray. Dear God, Heavenly Father. Oh, Father God, we just want to thank you, dear God. Lord, our cups have been full and running over this morning, dear God. Lord, we just thank you for our praise team this morning, dear God, who woke us up just to let us know, dear God, who you are, dear God, who you are. Thank you for the witness. Thank you for that testimony, dear God. Lord, we're just so blessed to be able to praise you so freely, dear God. Lord, we thank you for this church, dear God. We thank you for the shepherd that you have sent us, dear God. Let us give her our best, dear God.
Amen.
Let us continue to do what you want us to do, dear God. We just thank you, dear God. Lord, as we look around the world, dear God, and we see what's happening, dear God, we look at the in the States, dear God, we look at the that just took place, dear God. We thank you for Joe Biden, dear God, a man of God, a man of faith, dear God. And truly we can say, there's nobody like Jehovah. God sent him and Sister Palmer, dear God. Let us pray for her. Carla Harris, dear God. Because there's nobody like Jehovah. There's nobody like Jehovah. All over this world, dear God. We know that COVID is still around us. But thank you, Lord, we can worship freely, dear God. We can worship freely, dear God. We don't have to come with a
like those without no hope, dear God. Because there's a defend, dear God. There's nobody like Jehovah. And God told us that if we put our faith and our trust in him, dear God, and he's true to his word. He's true to his word, dear God. Like the little boy said, if I can just find the cross, just take me to the cross, that church with the cross on it, then I can find my way home. So we can find our way home, dear God. We can find our way to the COVID, because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. So let us re-pray this morning. Let us settle back and allow God to enjoy the service. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thus far in the service. And I see a little strange in here.
from Isaiah 43, verses 1 to 7 and 18 and 19. If you would like to stand, it would be grateful. But now, this is what the Lord says. He who created you, Jacob, he who formed you, Israel, do not fear. I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I'll be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. For I am the Lord your God, O Israel, O one of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt for your ransom, Cush and Seba in your stead. Since you are precious and honored in my sight, and because I love you, I will give people in exchange for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not be afraid, for I am with you. I will bring your children from the east and gather you from the west. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not hold them back. Bring my sons from afar, and my daughters from the ends of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Verses 18 and 19, forget the former things. Do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs up. Do not perceive it. I am making a way in the wilderness and a stream in the wasteland. Our overall theme for this quoted is moving forward. This is the word of the Lord. Thank you so much. My theme today is letting go of the past and moving forward. We have to let go of some things. God wants us to know that the past has no power over us, and that we can let go of it because we have been renewed by his love, redeemed by his grace. So rather than changing negatively because of our unfair past, we should only show God's love working in us by saying, I am nice, I am smart, I am forgiving, and I am sweet. Lift up yourself to praise God for who you are and let Jesus come into your heart. Because of Christ's love and forgiveness is in my life and is in your love, like we are here today. It's no longer I who lives, but Christ lives in me. So I live in this earthly body by trusting the Son of God who loved me and he gave himself up for me. Galatians 2:20. The scripture says, fear not. God was speaking to Israel. And the same as God spoke to Israel with the fear not, he's speaking to us with the fear not. Don't be afraid to move forward. It's knowing you belong to the Lord. But now, thus says the Lord, who created you, O Jacob, and he warned you, O Israel, fear not. I have redeemed you. I have called you by name. You are mine. We are children of God. Says the Lord, who created you, he who formed you. God speaks to his people as their creator. God has a special and unique claim upon us because he created us. That is why we can move forward in 2021. Get all excited because Jesus got great things in store for us. God tells us to have no fear because he is with us. Fear not. This command, Judah was afraid of Babylon's army and exile, but God points to them to the past, present circumstances, to both this command and promise. He said, I redeemed you. Not only did Israel have obligations to God as their creator, but also as their redeemer. He is the one who brought them out of exile and spiritual slavery. God was moving them in another direction, debt that they could not pay. When God calls himself our Redeemer, he paid the price that we must be his children, and he is our Savior. Jesus said, I have called you by your name. You are mine. God twice owns his people. He has the right of ownership, both as a creator and redeemer. His ownership of us is personal because he says, I have called you by name. Do you believe Jesus called you by name? Jesus knows everybody's name that's in it. Jesus even knows every string of hair on our head. His ownership is creation in his creation because he sealed it by saying, you are mine. When you know that Jesus are yours, don't you feel good to know you are here this morning because you are his? And I can move you forward. He tells us he can move us forward. Only God can move us forward. We can't do a thing without God. We have to put our trust in him. We have to love ourselves first so that we can love others, so that we can move forward and bring something to the table to keep us moving. Knowing that we belong to the Lord is a wonderful answer to fear. We can know that he holds us, he protects us, he guides us, he cares for us. We can know that he is our creator, our redeemer, and he calls us unless he intended to finish his work in us. We cannot be afraid because God started a work within us and God is going to finish the work in us. He is looking out for our interests as we move forward. Jesus said, when you walk through the fire, you will not burn. The flames will not set you ablaze, for I am the Lord your God. We must not be afraid to move forward when God is on our side. We must pick up our cross and follow Jesus. No looking back. Pick up our cross and follow Jesus. Genesis 19:26, when it talks about Lot's wife. Lot's wife looked back from behind him when she was directed and they were to move forward. And she became a pillar of salt. The moral of this Christian's top example is Christians shouldn't look back at their sinful ways, as that is the path to death. Actually, this is one interpretation. The other is obedience. Being that she turned back, she was disobedient. We do not want to turn back because we want to be obedient to God. Let us be obedient and not look back. Jesus promised, when you pass through the waters, he said, I will be with you. Through any personal obstacles, God will be with us. In deep waters, he will be with us. When we walk through the fire, then you shall not be burned. When God is with us, he is for us. Who can be against us? People can be against us only if we allow them. Amen. We just need to say, get on, get on. I'm giving you to God. I'm moving forward and move forward. Israel had their trials, and we have ours also. Trials are inevitable. It doesn't say if you pass through the waters. It says when you pass through the waters. The text doesn't say when you walk on luxurious padded carpets. It says God will be with us throughout our circumstances. Trials are varied. Sometimes we face waters, sometimes we face rivers, and sometimes fire. Floods overwhelm, fires consume. The mention of the Lord's presence and protection is the fire remains of the story of the three sons of Judah cast into Babylon's furnace because they would not bow down and worship idols. They were preserved in the fire by the presence of God. Even though they thought when the three men was thrown into the fire furnace that they was going to be burned, but they were not burned. God was with them and he saved them. This passage is also full of images of Exodus from the Egyptians. The statement, I am your Lord, God. God reminds every Jewish leader of Exodus 20, where the divine deception is followed by the words, who brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery? So learning from the past events, they could rest his promise to bring them again into their own land. We must trust Jesus because there's no one like Jesus. And Jesus tells us to trust in him. God said, since you are precious in my sight, here describes the motivation for his work of redemption. He loves us. We are precious in his sight. This is an Old Testament example of the truth. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believed in him would not perish, but have everlasting. So fear not, for I am with you. I will bring your descendants from the east and to the west and from the north and to the south, whom I created for my glory. We were created for the glory of God, and we must let our light shine and show that we are on fire for Jesus, because God means that we are created and he loves us, that he created us for a purpose. Have you ever thought, what is your purpose? We all have talents. We have the Creator, and then we are not useless. But God has created, and he did it for a purpose, creating us for his glory. This means that when you're glorifying God, we are fulfilling the purpose that we were created for, and will therefore be the happiest, fulfilled people. Happy, happy. Are you happy today? Did you come here happy today? Praise God, praise God. He woke us up this morning. He didn't have to wake us up, but he did. So we can be happy. What makes you happy? Let us get on board. Let us get on board. As it says, forgetting the former things, do not dwell on the past. See, I am doing a new thing. If we keep dwelling on the past like what it used to be, and this is not that way, or dwelling on what somebody else ain't doing right, or you're cutting in on my territory, we're going to keep ourselves in a state where we don't want to be. We got to forget about the past. He said, now it springs up. Do you not preserve it? I am making a way in the wilderness and streams in the wasteland. We are moving forward because God is making a way for us to move forward. What are we bringing to the table? Philippians 2:13 says, for it is God who is at work in us, both to will and to work for his good pleasure. And Galatians 2:20 says, I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ lives in me and he lives in you. I now live in the flesh. I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and he gave up himself for me. Once we believe and we begin to allow Jesus to rule over our life, he is able to start a new work inside of us. And we are new creations in Christ. And he can use what little we have for the glory of God. You don't have to have a great big thing, know everything, because when God chose his disciples, he didn't choose people who were trained and well and everything. He just come along and said, come follow me. And they followed Jesus and Jesus equipped them. So have the glory of God within us. Your talents, skills, and desires are not useless, and they will not go to waste in the hands of the Lord. But we first need to accept it, that him who is at work in us, Jesus is working in us. I don't know about you, but I know he is working in me. Sometimes I'm up, and sometimes I'm down. Sometimes I can't sleep. But God always gets me where I want to be, and he gets me there on time. And we need to remember that there's no work that we can do that adds to or takes away from the finished work of Christ. When Jesus created this earth, he finished his work, and he created us with his glory to do our work. This church is full of talent and creative minds. Use your skills for the glory of God. You have a lot to bring to the table. We must trust God, pray, and God will receive us, and He will show you what He wants you to bring to the table. You already have it in here. It's just letting them. Don't hold back. Nothing is too small for you to bring to the table. We got to come together. What can you really bring to the table? Try bringing the fruit of the Holy Spirit, which is in biblical terms, that sums up 9 attributes of the person or community living in one accord. Let us try to live in one accord with the Holy Spirit. According to chapter 5 of Galatians, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And I'm saying, add some forgiveness and respect. And let's bring that for each other and bring that to the table. And when we bring that to the table, there's nothing in God's creation that's going to stop us from moving on. We're going to have our ups and downs because God never promised us a bed of roses, but He promised He would never leave us, that He would always be with us. So what does Isaiah 43:17 mean? In Isaiah 43, God assures us that He will redeem us when we pass through the difficulties as given in the chapter. Water, rivers, flames, and fire. God protected Israel, and He will protect us. In verse 2, God says He will protect them as they walk through the waters, rivers, fire, and flames. And He did do this. He protected them as they walked on dry land through the Red Sea, and when they crossed the River of Jordan, the reference of fire and flames may refer to Daniel 3, 3 friends, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, in the fiery furnace, Daniel 3:16, recorded in the Old Testament. God's protection was with them, and God's protection is with us now. In verse 3 of this chapter, God says that He is the Holy One of Israel and Israel's Savior. He is our Holy One and He is our Savior. This is the first of many statements in the book of Isaiah, which states God is a Savior, especially starting in Isaiah 43:11. He was, the Savior of a nation in the sense that He protected them. He had rescued Israel from Egypt. God was Israel's rescue, and He is our rescue and will move us forward. Do you believe that?
Amen.
He will, but we want to go that way. We got to look ahead and not behind.
Thank you so much.
God refers to Himself as Savior in the Old Testament before Jesus arrived, and become our Savior to forgive us our sins. God is a Savior when He forgives our sins and saves us from physical harm. When studying the Bible, we see that God used the least likely people to do some of the most amazing things for Him. He chose the adulterer, the murderer, the thief, the prostitute. God used them as examples for us. Goes to show, no matter what we do, God can pick us up, turn us around, and move us forward. But we was looking at these people and putting them down. It is difficult. We need to dig deep into their lives and ask, what got them into this? What can we do to help to walk side and bring them along instead of putting people down? So remember, God can use anyone. God can even raise Preston to stones if He don't get the numbers that He wants. Believers need to quit living in the past because God wants us to focus on what is ahead of us and forget what happened yesterday or many years ago. Times is changing. Things are changing. God has never changed. we got to move forward and move on. We're going to have some bumpy roads, but God never brings us too far down that he can't bring us up. And believe it, you got to tell yourself, God is working in us, and God is going to get up through those bumps, and we're going to move on. God wants us to heal everything that hurts us, but first we have to choose to let it go. And that's the problem. We have to choose to let it go. When we choose to let things go, just like David, we need to acknowledge our sins and we need to ask God for forgiveness. We must get our eyes off the past and fasten them upon the power of the Lord. The writer of Hebrews tells us, fix our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith. Hebrews 12:2. This cannot be done when our eyes are fixed on the past. God does not want us to go through life looking in the rearview mirror. It's time now to look ahead and focus on what's before us. God wants us to do a new thing in our lives. He wants us to rise up to our full potential in him. Many of you have so much potential. Let's use it for the glory of God. The Lord has called us to do mighty things. He will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers in the desert for us. We have to keep moving forward. It is only in moving forward that we will accomplish what God has called us to do. We cannot stay where we are, nor can we go backwards. The only directions that we can go is forward. So let's move on and keep our eyes focused on God and just grow, just as it is written. Things which eye has not seen and ear has not heard. While there is a place and a time to reconcile, recollect the events of the past to gain a heart of wisdom, there is also time to just let go. Release it. The Apostle Paul said, not that I have already obtained it, for I have already became perfect, but I press on so that I may hold of the, that I may hold of that for which also I was laid hold of by Christ Jesus, Philippians 3:12. We have to keep moving forward. It is only in moving forward that we will ever accomplish what God has called us to do. We cannot stay where we are, and we cannot go back. Our only direction is that we can move forward. And let's move and keep our eyes focused on Jesus. Do you think that's possible?
Amen.
Anything is possible when we trust Jesus. I am so blessed to be here in this position for this period of time, and I'm asking God to lead me, direct me, give me a vision so that we can move forward in love. And we know we can. We know we can because it says here many times in this, what I said this one, read Isaiah 43, the whole chapter. Observe it, let that be your book for this week and see the message that God is giving us. Jesus is my light and Jesus is your light, and let us let our light shine because God is going to work in us. Don't sit down motivating what didn't happen, what did happen. Get angry. Get that angriness out of us and move forward. We know that some of us are hurting, but we can't live on that hurt. We got to move beyond our hurt, and we know Jesus can take us beyond if we move forward. So I'm asking you to trust God and bring a vision to you. What does God want East Preston United Baptist Church to do in 2021? And what can you do to make it happen? And pray and ask God to give you a vision to move forward and get some out of the way and let Jesus lead you, and you will do great things. I know if I don't know if there's anybody in this church today that is unsaved or don't know Jesus, but I'm going to throw the invitation to you. There may be somebody here who is from another church or something thinking about joining a church. We welcome you. We welcome you. Because God needs workers in his vineyard. And God knows we need to pray for young people. We need young people in our church to move us forward. All of us is getting older, but we need someone to step in and continue. And let's work alongside. Give them something to do. I am because people came and people gave. We had a good year financially, and we had a church meeting yesterday. We was like a roller coaster. We had our ups and downs, but we still come through, but we're not finished. And we're going to have a few more ups and downs.
Amen.
But we're going to get through our ups and downs. I am not the least bit worried, because I know that God is going to bring us through. We're going to have a few more meetings to get things straightened out, but that's going to happen. We can't straighten ourselves out, but I know a man who can.
Amen.
And that man is Jesus Christ. So thank you so much for listening to me this morning. There's no clock here, so I may went overboard, but I just pray that you'll forgive me. I know they tell us, the health department, 1 hour, you got to be out. But when the Spirit of the Lord is in you, you move on. So I thank you for your patience. I thank you for coming. And let us continue to pray for our congregation, those who still are in, you know, fear or not able because of health reasons to come. But let us pray when they say people with asthmatics and diabetes and all of that stuff, you know, is the ones that should stay behind. I forgot I was a diabetic. I forgot I had asthma. But praise Jesus, I haven't had near attack in 6 years. I haven't had a cold in 6 years. I trust Jesus. Every morning I wake up, I say, Jesus, Jesus, I can heal it in the name of Jesus. When I went to my doctor last week, she done took me off of 3 pills. She took me off of blood pressure pills a year ago, and she said, your blood pressure is like a teenager. So when I go to her, she's keeping taking me off of that stuff that my other doctor gave me. She said, ever since I've seen you for 2 years, there's nothing changing. Whatever you do, keep doing it. And so I'm going to try to eat right, sleep right. As I said, right now I'm pretty tired, but anyway, God's going to let me go home, go to bed, and rest for the day. So thank you so much. I pray you all have a good day. And thank you. Selection, and then we will offer the benediction. So you can all stand. Go well and stay safely. Amen.